Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are the way that leads to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the truth revealed in word and sacrament. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the life, the cornerstone of our faith. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may, under your protective care, bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men filled with spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was accepted to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith in the Holy Spirit, and also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks to the Lord, for he mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, His mercy endures forever.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And, like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, a stone that will make people stumble and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's gospel is one that is often chosen by family members as they go through the often difficult process of planning a funeral liturgy for a departed loved one. The church offers many beautiful and meaningful scripture passages to console us and remind us that just as Jesus died and came back to life, so will those who believe in him. This particular gospel passage is one that I suggest people take some time to reflect upon, putting themselves in the room with Jesus as he tells them he is leaving them. So let us put ourselves in the room for a moment. We have been following Jesus almost 3 years. We saw him work many miracles. We heard him tell us of a wonderful new kingdom. We learned about God's tremendous love for all of us. Now we hear Jesus saying he is leaving us. Like the disciples, we also might wonder if we are ever going to see the Lord again. Jesus, knowing our thoughts, reassures us by telling us that he indeed is going away, but will come back again someday and take us to himself. We probably would not understand that since, like the disciples, we had not yet experienced seeing the risen Lord. Jesus speaks of a dwelling place, a place where there is plenty of room. The question has often been posed, what happens when there is no more room in heaven? Today's gospel reminds us that there will never be such a time. There is room for everyone in heaven. And that is good news. The next question is, how do we get there? Thomas the Apostle asks the question, and the rest of us in the room are intently listening for Jesus' answer. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one goes to the Father except through me. What does that mean? It means that if we wish to get to that special dwelling place Jesus is preparing for us, the place we call heaven, we have to go through Jesus. We must see him as the way, the truth, and the life. We must listen to what he has to say to us and put his teachings into practice in our daily lives. He must be our top priority. As Saint Benedict once said, we must prefer nothing to Christ. We are beginning the fifth week of the Easter season, and at least in our part of the world, new life is beginning to burst around us in the springtime energy. Colors of gray and brown are replaced by green and other colors that remind us of warmth. Grass is beginning to grow, and perennials are breaking through. Light is replacing darkness, and life is replacing death. As St. Peter reminds us today in the second reading, we are a royal priesthood that began with our baptism. We have been called out of the darkness to share our faith. May we embrace our role and our hope as easily as the springtime flowers respond to the rays of the ever-increasing sunlight. May God's grace today nourish us with all that we need to go out into the world, even remotely, as we must do in so many ways these days, and share our faith, calling people, as the Lord has called us, out of darkness into his own marvelous light. The message given by Jesus is, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Let that be the message that we bring to others by our words and our deeds. Today is Mother's Day, a day that we set aside to let our mothers know how much we appreciate all that they have done for us. It is also a time to pray for our mothers who are no longer with us. So I would now like to offer a blessing for all of our mothers today. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Happy Mother's Day to all of our mothers. Now together we stand and make our profession of faith as we recite the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As people called by God, a chosen race, a royal priesthood, let us present our needs to him with confidence. For all of us baptized into Christ's church and the royal priesthood, may the Lord continue to increase our faith for the sake of his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in positions of authority, may God's grace enable them to lead with integrity, protecting life from conception through natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bishop Conlon, as he begins his retirement, may God bless him for all he has done for the diocese, and may his years ahead be fruitful. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our mothers and all women of faith who have given us life-giving love, may we show them reverence and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Marilyn and Andrew, who were to have been welcomed into the church this Easter, may the Holy Spirit continue to form them as they wait for the day when they may celebrate their sacraments and join our parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, especially those suffering from COVID-19, our military wounded, and those on our parish prayer list, may Jesus offer them healing and strength. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, especially Barbara Charlton, Miriam Lames, Francis Lang, our deceased mothers, and those who have died from COVID-19, may he who has prepared a place for them welcome them to the splendor of their heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers we offer in the silence of our hearts. And for all the prayers written in our book of petitions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, you know our needs before we ask. Please hear and answer our prayers this day according to your will. We ask all this in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Center of my life, I will.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in the sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourselves, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Bishop, and Richard, our Apostolic Administrator, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now we share with each other a greeting of peace.
On your stay, we toys the
away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I am. across the barren desert, but he shall not die of thirst. He shall wander far in safety. We do not know the way. You shall speak.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. We go in peace. Thanks be to God. During the month of May, we traditionally honor our Blessed Mother with special devotions. One of those devotions is the beloved May crowning, where Mary is honored as our spiritual mother, the one who loves us and is always ready to intercede to her son, Jesus, for us. We will now have our May crowning with the singing of Immaculate Mary as I go to the Marian shrine in our church. When I arrive at the shrine, we will then recite the Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary and close with the singing of On This Day, O Beautiful Mother. Now begin with the singing of Immaculate Mary.
Ave, Ave, Maria, Ave, Ave, Maria.
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Please respond to the following invocations with, "Have mercy on us." God, our Father in heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
And please respond to the following invocations with, "Pray for us." Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Most honored of virgins,
pray for us.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
Mother of divine grace,
pray for us.
Mother most pure,
pray for us.
Mother of chaste love,
pray for us.
Mother and virgin,
pray for us.
Sinless mother,
pray for us.
Dearest of mothers,
pray for us.
Model of motherhood,
pray for us.
Mother of good counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Virgin most wise,
pray for us.
Virgin rightly praised,
pray for us.
Virgin rightly renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin most powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin gentle and mercy,
pray for us.
Faithful virgin,
pray for us.
Mirror of justice,
pray for us.
Throne of wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our joy,
pray for us.
Shrine of the Spirit,
pray for us.
Glory of Israel,
pray for us.
Vessel of selfless devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of ivory,
pray for us.
House of gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the Covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of heaven,
pray for us.
Morning star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Comfort of the troubled,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of angels,
pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs and prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of apostles and martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of confessors and virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of all saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the Rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of families,
pray for us.
Queen of peace,
pray for us.
Please respond to the following invocations with, "Have mercy on us." Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
And please respond to the following invocation with, "That we may be worthy of the promises of Christ." Pray for us, Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
And let us pray. God of mercy, listen to the prayers of your servants who have honored your handmaid Mary as mother and queen. Grant that by your grace we may serve you and our neighbor on earth and be welcomed into your eternal kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will now close our celebration with the singing of "On This Day, O Beautiful Mother."